Namaste children, welcome back to another session of our science class. Today we are going to start a new block, that is your crop production and management. So we all know that all living organisms, they will get food from the plants and animals, and for the energy purpose and for nutrition purpose, mainly we want food, either for the energy or for the nutrition purpose. We want food, and the science that is dealing with the growth of plants and animals for human use, we are calling it as a agriculture. So in this today's class, we are going to learn about agriculture, how it is started, the types of crops based on the seasons, and few methods of crop production we will start. Okay children, so remember, every living organism, for its survival, it needs energy, and that energy it is getting from the nutrients from the food. And the branch of science that is dealing with the growth of plants and animals for human use, because humans are eating both plants and animals food, and the branch of science that is dealing with the growth of plants and animals for human use, we are calling it as a agriculture. Okay, so this agriculture, it is the world's most important industry even till today, because every living organism food, no? So agriculture is the world's most important industry, which is almost started before 10,000 years ago. Because before that, humans, they used to wander. Your Eliman, he used to wander, and when he is wandering from one place to another place, he used to eat the raw foods, vegetables, hunted animals, and used to eat the flesh of the two animals. But when he discovered that planting of seeds, means by his clear observation, when he understood that the seeds are getting turned, or they are giving rise into plants, so they settled at one place and started doing the crop production. So over the years, now this crop production, it became as an agriculture, which is one of the most important large scale industry, where the livelihood of so many people are depends on the agriculture. Even in India till now, if you will see, the 70% of the population works are from the agriculture sector still today. Yes, because directly or indirectly, different industries that were established related to the agriculture, like your fertilizers industries, pesticides industries, the machines that are used in the industry, the tractors, harvesters, the laborers who are working in the agricultural lands as a daily wage earners, the seeds industry. So directly or indirectly, different varieties of industries that are working based on the agriculture. So still we are saying that agriculture is one of the most important industry in our world. Yes, so even nowadays, different research works that are going on for the better crops and for higher yields. In our India, if you will see, in the years of 1960, the Green Revolution that is started, where we tried to produce a lot of rice from the plants. Okay, so still remember, 70% of the Indian people are truly depending on the agricultural industry only. So now let us see the different types of crops. Okay, so we can divide the crops based on the season where they are growing. Okay, so here if you will see, we can divide the plants into two different groups based on the season where they are dividing. First one is your kharif crops, the crops that are grown sown mainly in the rainy season, like your paddy, maize, groundnut, cotton. These are the crops that are mainly grown in the rainy season. Such type of crops, we are saying them as a kharif crops, which starts from the June onwards and ends till September, are the initial days of your October. And the second season, second type of crops, that is your rabi crops, where the crops we are saying as a winter season crops are the crops that are growing in the winter season, like your wheat, gram, peas, mustard. These are the crops that are winter season crops, where the sowing of seeds starts from October till it is carried harvest, it is done in the month of March or April. Such type of crops we are saying as a rabi crops. So based on the season means the climatic conditions, we started dividing the crops into two categories. One is a kharif crop and the second one is rabi crop. So kharif crops are your rainy season crops which are growing in the months of June to September, and these crops, they need a lot of water for their growth. So this type of crops which are grown in the sowing of seeds started from the month of June and harvestation it is done from the month of September or October. This type of crops we are saying as a kharif crops, whereas the second one, that is your rabi crops, these are the crops that are grown in the winter season, means sown at the stage of your October month and harvestation it is carried in the month of March. So this type of crops we are saying as a rabi crops. So these are some of the examples of your kharif crops: rice, maize, cotton, groundnut. So these crops, they always need a lot of water, plenty of water for their growth. That's what rainy season is an appropriate period for the growth of these type of crops. Whereas the rabi crops, that is starting from the month of October or November and harvest it is done in the month of April, these crops does not require much more water. Yes, so crops like your grams, peas, wheat, barley, these type of crops we are saying them as a rabi crops. So along with this kharif and rabi crops, some zaid crops are also there which we are saying as a summer crops, like your fruits and vegetables. And there is a specialized branch of science which is dealing with the production of our cultivation of fruits and vegetables in a larger scale, that is your horticulture. Horticulture, it is a branch of science which is dealing with the production of your cultivation of your vegetables and fruits in a larger scale. Okay, so now let us observe the picture carefully, children. This picture, it is giving an information for us about the different steps that are involved in the cultivation process or in the crop production process. Okay, so observe these steps one by one carefully. So in the first step you will see, that is preparation of soil. The second step, that is sowing of the seeds. Third step is manuring, that is supplying fertilizers or manures to the soil. And then followed by the supply of water, which is nothing but the irrigation process, which is nothing but your irrigation process. Yes, then removal of the unwanted plants or removal of the pests that are growing on it. And then weeding, that is removal of the unwanted plants. Then harvestation, which is done by threshing or winnowing methods, and then storage. So these are some several steps that are involved in the agriculture, starting from the preparation of soil till the storage of seeds or still the harvestation process. There are several steps that are involved in the agriculture which must be implemented in a systemic manner, then only we can get a higher yields. And even the soil, it maintains its nutrient values. Okay, so the proper maintenance of soil nutrients and to get a higher yields from the agricultural lands, we should follow all these steps in a systemic manner, then only we can achieve a good yield with the proper maintenance of soil nutrients for the next crop. Okay, so let us start with the first step in the crop production, that is preparation of soil. So why should we prepare the soil? What we will do in this preparation of soil? So soil, you know that it anchors the roots of the plants, and then it provides the nutrients and water for them, and even it also provides oxygen for the roots. And you know that soil, it is rich sources of microbes, earthworms. These all are called as farmer friends. Your earthworms, mainly those are called as farmer friends, which are meant for keeping the soil fertile. Yes, so the proper maintenance of microbes and for the aeration of roots. Okay, and then even for the supply of nutrients and water to the plant, preparation of soil is one of the most important method that must be followed by every farmer. So what we will do in this preparation of soil? So in this preparation of soil, we will till, either we will follow the tilling or we even can say it as a ploughing method. So in this method, we will loosen the soil. So what happens if we will loosen the soil? So when if we will loosen the soil, that soil has a lot of trapped air that is present in it that can easily used up by the roots and they can breathe easily. So the first purpose is for the breathing of the roots, we have to loosen the soil. Now the second one is if we will loosen the soil, then the roots can easily penetrate into the deeper layers of the soil and then the plant can stand firmly. So for the deeper penetration of roots inside the soil, we are loosening the soil. And even when you will loosen the soil, you can help the growth of microbes, and even you can help the growth of earthworms, which are acting on the decaying material present in the soil, and they will further loosen the soil and convert the soil into humus, which is most important for the plant growth. Yes, and when you are doing this ploughing or tilling process, that time what happens, the nutrients rich soil which is present as the second layer, that will come up and it will very easily for a plant to absorb much more efficient nutrients and it will grow healthily and gives a very good yield. And most important process for what we are loosening the soil is to level the soil. Sometimes when we are doing this ploughing or tilling, the process of loosening of soil or turning the soil, it's called your ploughing or tilling. So the main purpose of loosening of this soil is for the uniform distribution of nutrients, for the uniform distribution of nutrients all over the field. Sometimes when we are following this tilling method, that time we even observe that the soil, it will be like crumbs, hard soil balls will form. Under such condition, we have to break the lumps of the soil at first, and then it will be tilled and leveling of the soil is done, so that uniform distribution of nutrients all over the field, it is observed. So tilling or ploughing is a method where the process of loosening of soil is done, which is very much important, so that roots can breathe air easily, roots can penetrate deeper into the soil and they can uptake water properly. Leveling or ploughing, it is a process which is helping in the increasing the number of earthworms and microbes that are present in the soil, which further loosens the soil and makes the soil into humus. And when you are doing this tilling mechanism, the nutrient rich soil, it is coming up and helps the plant growth, and even it helps the uniform distribution of nutrients all over the field. So this is your ploughing method, where in the ploughing method we are using, in an ancient days, a wooden plough it is used, where at first when you will observe a plough shaft, this rod, it is called your plough shaft, is present, which is placed, yes, this end it is placed to two bulls, or even sometimes it is holded by the man. See here, the down part of the plough, it is connected with a sharp pointed iron, yes, which we are saying as a plough share, from with the help of that share, yes, we are going to till the soil. Yes, so this is an ancient plough, but nowadays this plough, it is replaced by the cultivators which are connected to the tractors, and we are tilling the soil. So this is the cultivator. Again, at the end of the cultivator you can see a sharp pointed iron one which will dig the soil and brings the nutrient rich soil out. Yes, so let us have a small look on this uses of plough for cultivator, children. Yes, children, after ploughing method, now the most important method, the second method that here we have seen, that is your sowing seeds. So before sowing seeds, before the sowing seeds only, the important method is selection of seeds. This is the most important method on which the entire agricultural yield depends, because in our market we will get different varieties of seeds. So out of the different varieties of seeds, which one is important, we should identify first. So selection of seeds is one of such important process. After that, after selecting the good quality of seeds, then we will go with the sowing of seeds. So let's have a small look on the selection of seeds activity, children. Generally we know that take seeds and pour the seeds into the water. So when you are pouring the seeds which are having lighter density, which are totally damaged and completely affected by the microbes, are the density of the seeds, because of the damage, if it is decreased, all such spoiled and damaged seeds, they will come and they will float on the surface of the water, and all good seeds, they will dip in the soil water. So by this method we can select the seeds, and such a good quality selected seeds that are used for sowing purpose. So let's have a small look on the selection of seeds activity, children.
First is preparation of soil, and after preparation of soil, the selection of seeds is done. The selection of seed is a very important step when we want to sow seeds in the field. We need to select healthy seeds so that the crop yield is good. Let us perform a simple activity which can show us that how the healthy seeds are selected. For this activity, I have taken a glass of water and few seeds which were available with me. You can take any kind of seed or whole pulses, chana, anything which is available with you. So to perform this activity, what I am doing, I am taking a half glass of water and I am putting a handful of seeds in this water. Now I'm going to mix it well. Let it get still and wait for some time. So students, what do you observe? Are there seeds which float on water? Yes, there are the seeds which are floating on water. Then why would these seeds are floating? Certainly, the things which are lighter in weight floats in water. So what have made these seeds lighter, and what have made the seeds heavier, which have sinked? Why would they be lighter? So damaged seeds, they become hollow and are thus lighter, therefore they float on water. So this is a good method for separating good healthy seeds from the damaged one. So before sowing, this is one of the important task to select healthy seeds and eliminate the damaged and unhealthy seeds. I hope you have enjoyed this activity.
So children, after selecting the good quality of the seeds by the activity, yes, we came to know how to select the good quality of the seeds, where the floated seeds are truly damaged seeds which are always floating on the surface of water, that should be separated completely, and the seeds that are dipped in the water are the good quality of the seeds. Select those seeds and sow those seeds in the agricultural land, which further changes into plantlets. So sowing of seeds is one such method which is also started advancement nowadays. So in the initial days, sowing of seeds, it is done by sprinkling method, or even the sowing of seeds in the initial days, it is done with the help of machines which is having a funnel like structure. So inside this funnel like structure, seeds are placed, and that funnel, it is having a cavity or a pipeline structure. So with the help of that pipeline structure, now the seeds that are sowed. But nowadays, because of the advanced in the technology, now these ancient seed sowing devices are replaced by seed drills. So seed drills, if you will observe, the drills, seed drills, they are having two rows of seed drills, and all the swaps of seed drills, they are arranged at a uniform distance. So now such a seed drill, it is connected to the tractor, and now the seeds are placed in these boxes. Slowly the seeds that are connected through the pipe, and with the help of these seed drills, they are placed in the soil, and inside the soil, and a layer of soil is also covered with the help of these seed drills. And one more important thing, that why we are using these seed drills, means within a short term period we can sow the seeds very easily. At the same time, all the seeds that are placed at a uniform distance, because sowing seed is also one of the major step in our particular agricultural process, where the seeds, if they are placed at a uniform distance, then they will not compete with each other for the nutrient, for air, space and all other purposes. Okay, yes. So such a uniform placement of seeds, it is done with the help of these seed drills, even which will decrease the cost of labors in the agricultural land. The most important use is all the seeds are uniformly placed at an equal distances, which will decrease the competition among the seeds for the purpose of nutrients, water, space, sunlight, everything. And at the same time, within a short term period, we can sow the seeds very easily, and it will even decrease the cost of the farmer. Okay, children. So in our today's class, we completed what is an agriculture, what are the different types of crops that are grown according to the season, and the different steps that are involved in the agricultural process. And after that, the first two steps in the agricultural process that we had seen, the first step is your preparation of soil, which is the basic step that must be followed by every farmer to loosen the soil for the uniform distribution of nutrients, and to enrich the soil nutrients, and increasing the growth of microbes, and even for the breath of the roots, and even for the regaining or restoring capacity of water by the soil, which is always followed by sowing of seeds, where selection of seeds is one of the best thing. After selecting a good quality of the seeds, go with the sowing method, and in that, the advanced methods in the sowing also we have completed. In our next class, we are going to start with the continuation of these steps in the agriculture, that is supplying manure to the crops, weeding process, irrigation process, and so on. Okay, children, open your textbooks and start reading the lesson. crop production and management and try to do the seed selection activity by your own and send me the videos. Okay, children, thank you so much.